now we are going to discussing about ricerpic acid and its molecular formula is C22H28N2O5. Let's see how the structure is. Just it is similar to just ricerpine. Here, see how the right structure. Okay, this is the structure of ricerpic acid. And first, now double bond equivalence. You know that the formula here, that is double bond equivalence equals to number of carbons minus number of hydrogens divided by 2 minus number of halogens divided by 2 plus number of nitrogens divided by 2 plus 1. And here in ricerpic acid, the number of carbon atoms are 22 and hydrogens are 28. And two nitrogens will be there here, 1 and 2. Two nitrogens will be there and plus 1. Okay, if we are doing this one, you are 2, 2, 4 is 14. Okay, you are calculated this one, we get 10. Okay, see how the 10 is there here, one ring and three double bonds means 4. Here, one double bond, 5, and ring is there, 6, 7, 8, 9, and here, one double bond. So 10. Double bond equivalence for ricerpic acid is 10. And nature of nitrogens. Now we are going to discussing nature of nitrogen. And ricerpic acid reacts with acetic anhydride to form nitroso derivative. And similarly, just like in the ricerpine, ricerpic acid also reacts with acetic anhydride to form nitroso derivative. That means ricerpic acid will have secondary nitrogen. It indicates ricerpic acid contain secondary nitrogen. In the same way, ricerpic acid reacts with methyl iodide to form quaternary salt. Quaternary salt, which indicates the formation of quaternary salts, indicates there is a presence of tertiary nitrogen, which indicates presence of tertiary nitrogen, right? In the same way, third one, Geisel method, it is also used to identify the number of methoxy group present in the molecule. See here, so in ricerpine there are 5 methoxy groups present, so that's why 5 moles of methyl iodide will be formation takes place. Whereas in the ricerpic acid, only 2 moles of methyl iodide is formed. That means there is a 2 moles of methoxy group present. That means there are 2 methoxy groups present, that's why it will be formed as 2 moles of methyl iodide. And nature of oxygen, next. And ricerpic acid reacts with FeCl3, then no decolorization product will be there. Okay, no decolorization will be takes place. That's why there is no absence of OH group. There is a absence of OH group. Ricerpic acid reacts with FeCl3, so no decolorization will be there. That's why it indicates that there is no OH group will present. That means no phenolic OH group. Okay, no phenolic OH group. In the same way, the ricerpic acid reacts with sodium hydroxide and sodium bicarbonate, then formation of salt will be takes place. Here see, whereas in ricerpine there is a reaction of sodium hydroxide and sodium bicarbonate, there is no formation of takes place, but here there is a formation of salt takes place. That indicates that is nothing but there is a presence of acid group present in the ricerpic acid. So due to this acid group, there is a formation of salt takes place in the ricerpic acid. Okay, next, reaction with acetic anhydride. Reaction with acetic anhydride. See here, ricerpic acid reacts with acetic anhydride. This is the product formation takes place that indicates there is a OH group present in the ricerpic acid. See, due to this OH group, there is a reaction with acetic anhydride to form like this compound. Okay. Similarly, the dehydrogenation with selenium, okay? Se. And this is the reserpic acid, and it reacts with methanol in presence of HCl to form ester type compound. This is the reserpic acid methyl ester. This is the reaction takes place here. Here acid group converted into ester group, okay? And it undergo dehydrogenation with the selenium to form 11 hydroxy 16 methyl iobine, okay? What we are, reserpic acid reacts with methanol in presence of acid, it will give ester type compound, and it undergo dehydrogenation to form 11 hydroxy 16 methyl iobine, okay? This is the dehydrogenation with selenium. And next, the oxidation of reserpic acid. And reserpic acid undergo oxidation with KMnO4 to form 4-methoxy-N-oxaliase anthranilic acid. See, reserpic acid reacts with, means undergo oxidation to form this is the Hassel group, so you have to give the numbering here from 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 methoxy, N, this is the oxaliyl group, okay? This is the N oxaliyl anthranilic acid, okay? In these reactions, in these both reactions, here, the acid group, this acid group and this OH group are meta to each other. See here. Here the acid group presented 16 position. See numbering from given numbering here 1, 2, 3 like this. So here we get, here we get 16 like this. Here 16 and here 17 and this is 18. This 16 and methyl, and these are two meta to each other. So the 16 position acid group present, ultimately the 18th position must be in OH group present, okay? These two reactions will be indicates that this acid group and alcohol group must be in meta to each other. That is, if acid group is must be must if acid group is 16 position, then ultimately then alcohol group will be 18th position. And this methoxy group and NH group, here this is the one of the methoxy group. And it is meta to this nitrogen, okay? These two reactions will indicate that here this nitrogen and this methoxy group will be meta to each other, and this acid group and this OH group must be meta to each other. In the same way, this reserpic acid undergo reduction with lithium aluminium hydride, then what will happen? This acid group is there now. This acid group will be converted into alcohol group. This acid group will be converted into alcohol group, okay? And here, if this 11 hydroxy 6 methyl iobrine is undergo reaction with lithium aluminium hydride, okay? If it undergo reduction reaction, then the OH group will be removed. So, to form only 16 methyl this compound, okay? 16 methyl iobine compound is formed, okay? You have to remember these things. When this 11 hydroxy 16 methyl iobine is reacts with undergo reduction reaction with lithium aluminium hydride, then the OH group will be removed to form only 16 methyl iobine compound will be formed. In the same way, if the reserpic acid reaction with acetic anhydride to form a gamma lactones, okay? These are the lactone structure. It is alpha, beta, gamma. This is the functional group, right? So it be alpha, beta. Functional group addition is carbon is alpha, beta, and gamma. So this is a gamma lactone formation. When reserpic acid reacts with acetic anhydride, what we are forming? Gamma lactones will be formed. Okay? And which indicates that the hydroxy group and this acid group must be in matter to each other. This also the same way, whereas oxidation and reaction with something dehydration with selenium. So though both reactions will be indicates the same, the acyl group and OH group will be matter to each other. Similarly, the sulfuric acid reacts with acetic anhydride to form gamma lactones, which also indicates that this acyl group and OH group must be in matter to each other. I know the going the stereochemistry of this reserpine. This is the reserpine structure and it undergo epimerization. Means here in third position, this take one, see here 1, 2, 3. At third position, the hydrogen must be in beta position, means a thick line. When undergo epimerization, the hydrogen undergo alpha position, that is dotted line. Okay, if the third position the hydrogen will be in thick line, then that is reserpine, and if the hydrogen in dotted line, that is isoreserpine. Okay, here see, this is, let's say, here see, this Z group must be a indole moiety. If this Z is an axial position, means this indole moiety in axial position, then it will be a reserpine. Okay, if the Z group, that is this indole moiety will be in equatorial position, then it will be a isoreserpine. You have to remember, this is a reserpine structure. Okay, here the methoxy group is there. This is the structure of reserpine, and here thick line and dotted line indicates there is a presence of chiral center. Okay, here one chiral center, here one chiral center, here one chiral, here and here, here. So both in reserpine contain six chiral centers are present. Okay, here thick line and dotted line indicates that there is a presence of chiral center. Okay, what is chiral center? The group which contain four different the carbon which contain four different groups, then that carbon is known as chiral carbon. Okay, here this thick line dotted line indicates that reserpine contain six chiral centers. Okay, thank you.